What is DOM? And how to use JavaScript for manipulating DOM? On every HTML page we have seen so many tags, div tag, span tag, body tag and so on. The DOM model looks at them from an object-oriented perspective and calls them objects. More specifically, these are called DOM elements. Let's look at this page from the angle of DOM. This is an element. This is an element as well. This too. Every tag is an element. Let me draw a hierarchical chart. The HTML page contains a head tag, which has a child called title tag. More could be there, like meta tags. Body tag is an immediate child of the HTML element. It contains a div. Could contain more tags, like img, span. Similarly, this div could be a container. HTML root element. Head and body. All elements in a DOM hierarchy are interlinked. Wandering orphans are not possible. A tag would be either a parent of some or a child of some. A DOM is a hierarchical tree. Let's have a look at the structure of an element. This is the opening tag. It closes here. This is an attribute called id. If specified, it should be a unique identifier. This is another attribute. Yet another. The attributes like id, class, style are predefined ones. But you can define your own tags also. You should start them with data. These are the values for attributes. And this is called inner HTML or text. to summarize, each DOM element has a unique id. A DOM element can have attributes. The content of an element is called its inner HTML. Let me show you the inner HTML. This is the inner HTML. In this div tag, id and custom data attributes can be seen. Inner HTML. Attributes can be classified. It is a special attribute. Then, there are predefined standard ones. There could be custom attributes. These look like data followed by a hyphen. Events and their handlers are also specified as attributes. These are DOM objects. The HTML document is a DOM object. The browser window 2 is 1. Div, span, etc., all are as well. Each DOM object is different. It has its own list of properties, events and functionality. Each object has its own documentation, clearly laid down in the DOM standard. There are a number of additional documented functions that could be used to manipulate an element. These all are together called the DOM API. We have properties. Functions or methods. Events. Let me explain this with the help of a concrete example. Document is a DOM element. It has a property called StyleSheets that can be used to get the list of the included CSS files. Likewise, it has a title property. Then it has a function called getElementBead. And it also an event. The list is too large to include here. We will now see DOM API at work. We shall write JavaScript here. The above div is a part of the document, so we can use getElementBead to obtain a reference to it. We can read the inner HTML property. And display it. As expected. You can use DOM API for programmatically altering an HTML document. Add, remove, modify. These are the ones we use more commonly. Create an element. Read HTML. Read or write attributes. Change CSS. Attach events. Of course, jQuery makes these tasks even easier, thank you.